I'm not a scientist, but I have a deep and abiding passion for it, and particularly the theoretical side, you know, the future. I'm spellbound by the possibilities that are being revealed all the time. And I don't have to be a scientist. I mean, there's some fantastic literature around, which is quite dense, but you don't have to understand pure maths to do it. And so that's probably my main reading, I suspect. Fascinating stuff. I think the most radical thing we did was the alternate universe, which, as you probably know, is incredibly feasible. And so it wasn't too much of a stretch in theory. And it's funny, I had a friend who was a scientist, when I was at university, and I shared a flat with him, and he's crazy. He's truly crazy. And I based Walter Bishop largely on him, to be honest with you. But we would sit down sometimes at nights, and we would work then on the laws of probabilities, that there must be, simply by the laws of probabilities, for example, an exact duplicate of what we are here. There must be, in an eternal. And so these sorts of thoughts have been with me for a very long time. And that my friend is still a crazy scientist and still fighting the establishment every chance he gets. It's like sliding doors, isn't it? You know, what happens in our life to take us in one direction or another? It was the same man with all of the same characteristics, the same level of intelligence, the same looks, but one went a certain path and finished up because of his work being put into a mental asylum and basically reduced to shambles. And the other one was put in a position of authority and therefore went on to become a state leader. Both the same men. And my favourite scene, maybe my favourite scene, you may recall, it was when the two of them finally got down to sit and have a talk to each other. And I'd always wanted that to happen. Then they shot this beautiful scene of just the two of us sitting in a corridor talking to each other intimately about something. Oh, such a joy to do. So, what happens with the show is that they really need to reboot each year. And I think all television series do that, unless it's just a straight procedural, like Special Victims Unit or something. Then that is a straight procedural, which very successfully goes. But with these types of shows, they really need to reboot, find another way. And that's what they had to do on, four occasions after the opening. So you don't really know. They also listened quite closely now to what the fans say, what works for the fans. And there were ideas, for anyone observing, that came in and just disappeared. Like, where did that go? It just disappeared because it wasn't progressing us.